Got a little Nugent playing on the turntable. So hard for me to decide what to do with my minutes, let me tell you. It's one of the hardest decisions I make each day. Do I accomplish something? Well, of course, I always do. We always do the basics, right? What are the basics? Well, just getting up in the morning, putting our feet on the ground, taking that shower, getting that day rolling. That's what we do. Now, hopefully, we got a good video shot here. Wow! There we go. So, we got a video shooting this morning. What's going to go on for my agenda for the day? Like I said, I don't even know. You know, I've been, sometimes I touch on the fact about when you help someone, if you're going to list for someone on eBay or sell something for them, it is taxing on your time. I'm still out of breath. Yeah, that's right. I'm out of breath. I'm an old man. Did you know that the life expectancy, a human's body is realistically only designed to live for 40 years? So anything above that, I'm 52. No, 51. Oh, knock on wood. I want 52. One at a time. One at a time. So, take care of your bodies. Remember, your teeth are your most important things. If you have bad teeth and you have holes in your teeth, cavities, and you're not taking care of it, that is an open line to your heart and it's just into your blood system. It's the number one in your gums is what's going to kill you. It does kill so many people each year. And speaking from the heart, I lived with bad teeth for too many years. But I was able to get them fixed a few years ago, and by meaning being able, I got up off my ass and went in and fixed the disgusting teeth that needed to be fixed and removed. And so that will give you extra life, and you'll feel better, and you'll feel healthy. It's huge. So there, other than the public service announcement there, fidgeting. And like I said, these videos have always been shot from the hip, meaning when I go to turn it on, I have an idea, but sometimes I don't even follow my own ideas and I just ramble. I turn on that faucet and I let it run and the faucet being my mouth. Too much energy, too pent up. It's because a lot of my time is taking care of the kids. And a lot of my time while I'm doing that, all I'm doing is thinking, I'm junking in my mind. I'm like, okay, I'm going to do this when I get some time off. I'm going to do that. I'm going to get out to the shed, cabin in the backyard. We're going to finish that roof and put a coating on it before the snow falls so we don't have any drippage down on our collectibles out there. I'm going to sell some things on eBay for my stepmother, remember? That's what I began this speech with, and how much time that takes. So that was probably last fall I began that process of helping her. And I went out there, and of course, it had all been my dad's stuff. So I was excited, and I got hyped up, and I took a lot of it. I must have taken probably 6 tubs worth of stuff so far. And I've sold maybe out of those. I brought back a few tubs, whatever. I've sold substantial for her. But then in the summer, I began to slow down because simply I had no energy or time. My energy was being taken up with taking care of the kids. And then just even when I did have any time, it was for myself. So time is our most valuable thing in life. If you have it, it is so precious. As you get older, you begin to see the value of it. It is more valuable than money. And so trying to stretch my time. And so then, like I said, my limited days that I do have off, what do I want to do? I want to crank the turntable. I want to rearrange my own collection. I trade, I flip, I sell stuff sometimes to enhance my collection, but basically this passion is all pure, and because I actually collect this stuff, I love it. So when I get time off, I want to just crank the turntable up, spin records for 2 hours and get lost in that. But that cannot be very productive at times, but then I allow myself to have that because that does fuel me. Always remember that, is because immediately the responsibility sticks its head in there and is just like, man, you've got things to do, but you must take care of your heart. And your heart is your passion, is your soul, and that's the things that you love in life. So if you hold those things away from yourself, you're going to slowly die. And so sometimes you just have to crank the turntable up because life is short. Enjoy it. And so you will actually get things done, but you're going to do things that you want to do for yourself. And that is putzing around, moving our collections around, deciding what we don't love anymore. That's a huge thing to do. And it's one thing that I am trying
very to face the reality of, yeah, I've gathered, you know, a hoard. Literally, Fred Sanford. That's what I'm sitting on right now. You have to remember that my situation, for those who don't know, is back in like 2000, I was a junk man. Lamont, Sanford and Son, estate cleanouts, driving the alley 7 days a week, all freaking day. In and out of dumpsters, going to the dump, estate sales, garage sales, everything. Just a beast. And so in that time, I accumulated, because you have to do that when those situations and you're living it and you're in that moment, you have to accumulate, because if you don't, you're going to blow it. And now, of course, you say, well, Mike, you should have sold it. I did. I sold tons of shit. That's how I put food on the table. That's how I put gas in the old van at the time to drive around and to get it. Find my videos. There's still some that was the tail end of it. Like 2009 is when I started to make videos. God, if I would have just had a camera, just like in 2000 on, I mean, the situations that I came upon, just meeting an old man in the alley, and then getting to go through his garage, and he'd been there, shit, 60 plus something years. He was an old railroad worker. This is just one story of millions. And this is where it breaks my heart that I didn't get all that stuff on film. But I can tell you about it, and I can tell you the story, and my memory is good. And I'd like to tell a story. I'd like to revisit the past. And we're going to round this video up and end it with that and the past and what that means to it. I was thinking this morning as I was doing the dishes, as my last daughter was getting ready to go off to school, because I like to have all the dishes done, everything, so that when I come down into my time, I don't have a bunch of bullshit responsibility hanging over my head. I've already taken care of it. I've kicked its ass. So, and why do I go back to my old neighborhood, which I hated in my youth, that I wanted to get away with? Because to me, it's like visiting the Titanic. I can go back there. I can visit it. It to me, it's like a museum. Flashes of my past, except it's my museum. So I encourage you, you know, even if you're from a place that maybe you don't have the best feeling about or whatever, go visit it, see it. Don't forget who you are. Don't live in the past, obviously. Don't dwell in the past, but it does shape you. And things that affect you are trauma, and the difficult things, you know, loss, and just things that hurt us as we develop and grow into old men. That play catch with themselves. Now, mind you, when I was a kid, I grew up a poor, dirty, poor kid in St. Paul, Minnesota. Single parent. No dad in sight. So I spent hours out in the football field. I would have football games with myself and, like, a football. I could literally do a full drive in an old empty lot by myself and play it out loud. I would be the announcer, everything. So when you see me throwing the football around down here in the basement, I spent hours doing that. That's how I entertained myself, playing war in the woods by myself. It was a different time. There was no YouTube. Thank God, because then I wouldn't have gotten out there and been so banged up and had a great story to tell and share with you. Everyone, get out there, kick some ass, throw something out today, list something on eBay, play some records, just kick it. Do what you need to keep yourself flourishing and climbing up that mountain. Give yourself a break if you need it. Rest, rest, rest. The other night, I was not feeling well. I had things to do, and I thought, F it. You know what? If I go to sleep right now at 7 o'clock, and I sleep all the way till tomorrow, I'm going to feel better tomorrow, and I will have energy to get more done tomorrow. And I'm starting to think like that, going into my 50s now. Sleep is the most valuable thing other than time, but sleep is time, isn't it? Whatever. Hey-ya! I've rambled too much. I gotta shut this video off, or we're way over 10 minutes. I'm sure I'm like at 16 minutes. Pitiful. I try to keep these videos at 10 minutes because then they load faster. Everyone, above ground, blast. Go out there, find a cool treasure, German helmet. That would be really rad. Doro.